Ever wondered how data is organized and accessed so efficiently in computing? From arrays to stacks and graphs, data structures are the essential building blocks of computer science and programming. Welcome to Whiteboard Doodles, the channel where we simplify tech-related concepts using whiteboard animations. Today, we're exploring the fascinating world of data structures, what they are, how they work, and why they're key to handling data effectively. Let's jump in. Data structures are specialized formats for organizing, storing, and managing data, enabling efficient access and modification. They are essential building blocks in programming and computer science, allowing developers to handle data in ways that optimize performance for specific tasks. Data structures are typically divided into two main types, linear and nonlinear. In linear data structures, such as arrays, linked lists, stacks, and queues, data elements are arranged sequentially, making them ideal for ordered data access. Nonlinear data structures, like trees and graphs, organize data hierarchically or through networks, supporting more complex relationships and enabling tasks like hierarchical data representation, pathfinding, and efficient searching. By selecting the appropriate data structure, developers can streamline algorithms, manage memory effectively, and solve computational problems more efficiently. Let's start with arrays. An array is a fundamental data structure that stores a collection of elements in a contiguous block of memory where each element is accessible by an index. Arrays are typically used when a fixed-size collection of homogeneous items, like integers, floats, or strings, is needed, as they allow quick, constant-time access to elements by index. One of the key strengths of arrays is their simplicity and efficiency in accessing data, making them ideal for tasks that require rapid lookup and straightforward data storage. However, arrays come with limitations. They have a fixed size, so expanding or contracting them requires creating a new array and copying elements, which can be inefficient. Additionally, inserting or deleting elements, except at the end, can be slow, as it requires shifting elements to maintain order. Despite these limitations, arrays remain widely used for their ease of use and fast, predictable access times. Next, let's take a look at linked lists. A linked list is a linear data structure where each element, called a node, contains the data and a reference, or link, to the next node in the sequence. There are several types of linked lists: singly linked lists, where each node points to the next node; doubly linked lists, where each node has links to both the previous and next nodes, allowing traversal in both directions; and circular linked lists, where the last node links back to the first, forming a loop. Compared to arrays, linked lists offer dynamic sizing, allowing for efficient insertion and deletion of elements without the need to shift other elements, making them well-suited for applications where frequent insertions and deletions are required. However, linked lists do not support constant-time access to elements by index, as they require traversal from the beginning to reach a specific node. This trade-off makes linked lists more flexible than arrays, but generally slower for direct element access. Now, let's dive into stacks. A stack is a linear data structure that operates on the last-in-first-out LIFO principle, meaning the last element added to the stack is the first one to be removed. Imagine a stack of plates. The last plate placed on top is the first to be taken off. In programming, stacks are commonly used for tasks where the order of operations needs to be precisely managed. Typical applications include managing function calls, where each new call is stacked on top and then resolved in reverse order. Stacks are also useful in algorithms that require backtracking, like navigating through mazes or solving puzzles, as well as in implementing features like the undo function in software applications. Now, let's move on to queues. A queue is a linear data structure that operates on the first-in-first-out or FIFO principle, meaning that the first element added to the queue is the first one to be removed. Think of a line at a ticket counter. The person who arrives first gets served first. In computing, queues are widely used in situations where order is essential, such as task scheduling, managing print jobs, or handling data streams. There are several types of queues, each with specific characteristics. The basic queue allows elements to enter at the rear and leave from the front. A circular queue reuses empty spaces by connecting the rear and front, useful for fixed-size memory buffers. A priority queue serves elements based on priority rather than arrival order, making it ideal for scheduling systems. Lastly, a deke, double-ended queue, allows insertion and deletion from both ends, providing greater flexibility for complex data management tasks. Moving on to nonlinear data structures, we have trees. Trees are a fundamental nonlinear data structure used to represent hierarchical relationships. Unlike arrays and linked lists, which organize data in a sequential manner, trees branch out from a single root node into a structure of connected nodes. Each node in a tree can have zero or more child nodes, creating a parent-child relationship. The root node is the starting point, and from it, nodes branch into subnodes, known as children, which can themselves become parents of further nodes. Trees come in various types, including binary trees, where each node has at most two children, and binary search trees, BSTs, where nodes are arranged to allow fast searching, insertion, and deletion. Trees are essential in applications like file systems, databases, and organizing data in searchable formats. Their hierarchical structure allows efficient access and manipulation of data, especially in tasks like sorting, searching, and representing nested structures. Next, let's take a look at graphs. Graphs are versatile and powerful nonlinear data structures that model relationships between objects. They consist of nodes, or vertices, connected by edges, which represent the links or relationships between pairs of nodes. Unlike trees, graphs don't have a single root and can contain cycles or loops, meaning a path might start and return to the same node. Graphs come in various types. An undirected graph has edges that are bidirectional, while a directed graph or digraph has edges with specific directions. Additionally, weighted graphs assign values or weights to edges, often used to represent distances, costs, or other metrics. Graphs are widely used in fields like social networks, where nodes represent people and edges represent relationships, computer networks, where nodes represent devices and edges represent connections, and in GPS systems for mapping routes and distances. Their flexibility makes them essential for modeling complex connections and optimizing processes like search algorithms and network flows. Moving on to hash tables. Hash tables are an efficient data structure that provides quick access to data through a unique key-value pairing system. They use a hash function to convert keys into specific indices or buckets within an array, allowing data to be located quickly without searching through the entire structure. Hash tables are widely used in applications that require fast data retrieval, like databases, caching, and symbol tables in compilers. They also play a role in certain cryptographic processes. If you're interested in learning more, check out our separate video on cryptography basics. The hash function is crucial, as it must minimize collisions when two keys hash to the same index, which can slow down retrieval. To handle collisions, hash tables use techniques like chaining, storing multiple items at the same index in a linked list, or open addressing, probing for the next open slot. This structure is particularly valuable for managing large datasets with frequent lookups, as it offers near-constant time complexity for operations like insertion, deletion, and search when optimized well. Up next, we have tries. Tries, or prefix trees, are a type of tree-like data structure used for efficient retrieval of strings, especially when managing large sets of words or sequences. Each node in a try represents a character of a string, and strings are constructed by tracing paths from the root node to specific endpoints. This structure is particularly useful for autocomplete and spell-checking features, as it allows quick searches, insertions, and deletions of words based on shared prefixes. For example, in a try storing words starting with app, the paths for apple and application would branch off from a common app prefix. Tries are efficient in terms of storage space when many words share prefixes, but they can consume significant memory with large datasets. By organizing data in a try, searches can achieve time complexity based on the length of the string rather than the total number of stored items, making them powerful for applications involving text processing. And finally, let's talk about heaps. Heaps are a specialized type of binary tree primarily used for efficient data retrieval, especially in priority-based applications. There are two main types of heaps, max heaps and min heaps. In a max heap, each parent node's value is greater than or equal to its children's values, making the largest element always available at the root. Conversely, in a min heap, the parent node's value is less than or equal to its children's, placing the smallest element at the root. Heaps are commonly used to implement priority queues, where elements with higher priority are processed first. They are also central to heap sort, an efficient sorting algorithm, and are useful in applications that require repeated access to the largest or smallest element, such as scheduling tasks or managing resources. In conclusion, understanding data structures is fundamental for efficient data management and algorithm design. Each structure, from arrays and linked lists to trees and graphs, serves a unique purpose, optimizing various operations like searching, inserting, and deleting data. Choosing the right data structure enables developers to enhance performance, conserve memory, and tackle complex computing problems with ease. Mastery of these structures not only strengthens problem-solving skills, but also opens doors to more advanced programming topics and applications. Embracing these foundational concepts is essential for anyone aspiring to excel in software development or computer science. This concludes our exploration of common data structures. If you enjoyed it, consider subscribing to our channel and liking the video. Feel free to also check out our other videos on related topics. Thank you for watching.